Hello, before we start, make sure to subscribe to this channel and hit the notification bell to receive updates when we upload new videos. For years, automakers told us no to half-ton diesel pickups. They won't sell, they'll be too expensive. There's no demand, just buy a 3/4 ton with the big 6.0 liter V8 engine. It's what you really want anyway. The Ram 1500 broke the trend in 2014, though, with the 3.0-liter V6 EcoDiesel, and the market responded. Flash forward a few years and the light-duty diesel truck market is hot. The Ford F-150 added a 3.0-liter diesel to its engine bay a few years back, and now the 2020 Chevrolet Silverado is set to join the fray with a Duramax diesel. Slated to arrive in the fall, delayed one model year after the Silverado arrived thanks to emission certification issues, the Bowtie's diesel differs from the competition in its layout. It's a 3.0-liter straight six. The inline engine is an important distinction versus the V6 engines offered by the competition. While performance is similar to the rivals, inline engines are inherently smoother, better balanced, and easier on the ears. Despite the different layout, though, the Silverado 1500 belts out 277 horsepower and 460 pound-feet of torque at just 1,500 revolutions per minute. The F-150 packs 440 pound-feet at 1,750, but the new Ram EcoDiesel packs 480 pound-feet at 1,600. In the Chevy's case, though, 95% of peak torque is available at just 1,250 revolutions per minute. Not only will this accessible power put a smile on your face, it helps get the load moving when towing. The off-the-line performance of the two-wheel drive extended cab Silverado RST impressed. With just a small throttle input, the Duramax diesel sprung to life and pushed us back in the seat. In fact, we were really thankful I had nothing in the bed, because it would have slammed against the tailgate. Putting the Silverado into sport mode alters the throttle input and transmission shift points, and makes for even more fun with the tires spinning under hard acceleration while exiting a corner on the twisting roads of rural Oregon. While the powertrain is new, the diesel-powered Silverado handles broadly like its V8-powered siblings. An attention grabber off the line, the 3.0-liter's power curve has no real drop-off in power at higher RPMs. While the engine's abundant power and torque is helpful, thanks should go, at least in part, to the standard 10-speed automatic, which manages the 3.0-liter's performance well, particularly when making critical moves like joining a freeway. Instead of deciding if you will be merging with the car slightly ahead of you, Chevy's powertrain combo allows you to plan to merge two cars ahead. It's that impressive. The diesel is also impressively quiet. Chevy added extensive sound deadening in the engine bay to quell the clatter commonly associated with diesel power. There's a thick piece of foam attached to the underside of the hood, a strip surrounding the hood latch, and then finally, and somewhat controversially for diesel aficionados, a timing belt instead of a timing chain. The belt dramatically reduces the noise coming from the engine compared to the chain. Officially, though, the EPA hasn't released estimated fuel economy numbers for the new Silverado. After driving it around, though, it won't be too much of a stretch for a two-wheel drive model to net over 30 mpg on the highway. For comparison, the F-150 nets 22 mpg city, 30 highway, and 25 combined. The Ram is slightly less impressive, at 20 mpg city, 27 highway, and 23 combined. The Silverado's 3.0-liter turbodiesel costs $3,890 more than the base turbocharged 2.7-liter four-cylinder, making it an easy upgrade in our eyes. At the same time, the straight six costs $2,495 more than the 5.3-liter V8. Again, that's an easy pill to swallow considering this engine's refinement, power, and likely fuel economy. With Chevy joining Ford and Ram in the diesel race, customers that have spent years begging automakers to build diesel half-tons are now spoiled for choice. Get truck shopping.
Thank you for watching, and don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video. Subscribe to Auto TV.